Well, at least 215 people have been killed from Hurricane Helene since it made landfall last Thursday. But that death toll could continue to rise as rescuers are now finally making their way into some of the hardest hit areas, searching for people who are still unaccounted for. Here's ABC's Alexis Christophorus with the details.
Search crews are combing through the remote mountains in western North Carolina, hoping to locate those still missing and those in need of supplies. Teams from across the country helping with those search and rescue efforts. Private helicopter companies stepping in to deliver much needed aid, including food, water, fuel, and over 100 donated Starlink satellite units.
We've just been distributing them to local fire departments who we know have been isolated with no comms, and it's fantastic.
In Asheville, the North Carolina National Guard working nonstop to deliver supplies to residents. ABC's Morgan Norwood is there.
These guardsmen have been working round the clock to help get aid into the disaster zone, but with so many roads closed, there's only so far they can go.
Duke Energy says they have repaired more than 1 million power outages in North Carolina, but about 170,000 customers in the mountains are still without power.
We're committed to continuing safe restoration until everyone's power is restored.
Duke says they're dealing with unprecedented damage.
Think about where power lines are normally located. There are easements along those roadways. Those easements are gone.
This substation in Swannanoa buried under the debris.
If we go down a little further, you see an 18-wheeler cargo container wrapped around one of our transmission towers.
Much of the small town, about 20 miles east of Asheville, washed away. Homes flattened, businesses destroyed, roads impassable.
Alexis Christophorus, ABC News, New York.
FEMA has launched a webpage dedicated to pushing back against misinformation about the federal government's response to Helene. The agency tackles rumors like one claiming it doesn't have enough money for disasters, which FEMA insists it does.